The city sanitation workers spent the whole of last week in protests, demonstrating against the prolonged non-payment of their wages and the forced association membership. Today, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, held a meeting with KCCA leaders, including the Lord Mayor Elias Lukwago, the Executive Director Dorothy Kisaka, the Minister for Kampala Affairs, Misa Kabanda, area members of Parliament, among others, to resolve the impasse.
We need to know which people are with them. The verification of these people. We need to have that done. You will find some other people who are not working coming on board and saying we are here to do the work.
The street sweepers, who organized in circles, have gone for 4 months without pay, prompting their peaceful protest in front of Parliament last week. Speaker Among has advised Kisaka to analyze the payment of the sweepers.
You are budgeting that was a development expenditure, whereas it's supposed to be a recurrent expenditure. So in this new budget that we are going into, we change from development to current, such that, because you know very well that current can never be delayed to be released. And the delay of the release is basically because you budgeted for it as a development expenditure. So we could check on that and make sure that we change it to...
The Minister for Kampala Capital City and Metropolitan Affairs, Hajat Misa Kabanda, applauded the resolution, saying it's going to restore relief at City Hall.
We have met several times. At least this time, I think we have resolved once and for all. And as a minister, I wish to say that we are going to at least see that everything is done as we have resolved here.
The Executive Director, Dorothy Kisaka, confirmed that payment will be affected on Wednesday, March 6, 2024.
The KCCA should immediately commence payment of any outstanding arrears to the circles. We should use the available funds, and as a technical team, we've said we'll start this effective tomorrow to commence these payments.
The Lord Mayor, Elias Lukwago, said the challenges arose from attempts to phase out the casual labourers under their circles in favour of one company, which he said has been adamant about absorbing the existing workforce.
Unfortunately, Right Honourable Speaker, in the process of awarding contracts, the institution or management, to be specific, deviated from that policy. And that has caused all these problems. If we had complied with that policy, we wouldn't be where we are now. It was very, very clear that we divide Kampala into 10 constituencies or units, and each circle would operate within that particular locality. And would give out bids for the three clusters of the services: cleaning, distributing, and landscaping.
He proposed the zoning of Kampala to accommodate the interests of the cleaners under their circles and also the company which has a running tender for city sanitation. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.